Gentlemen and ladies, and those that are in my YouTube analytic demographic, welcome to my final part of my reaction series, where I show you guys exactly what had changed and what hadn't changed by reacting to a podcast I did with the University of Surrey almost 5 years ago. Now, if you hadn't watched part one, if you hadn't watched part two, if you hadn't watched part three, if you hadn't watched part four, make sure you go watch these before you watch this part. And if you are watching this part, make sure to leave a like, share, and subscribe. You know, the notification bell, the notifications. That way, you never miss a video from yours truly. Now, without further ado, let's get on to this final part of the series. And I cannot wait for the content that I have coming up on this channel as soon as this is done. Without further ado, let's go. Pro wrestling got me into heavy metal hard. My heavy metal taste just went into crazy directions. At one point, I was listening to Belgian sludge metal, which was played by the band Amenra. And I found that band through a former Dutch-style kickboxer and Muay Thai practitioner, Malachi Black. When I found Amenra, I'm not even kidding you, my face would go fucking pale when I would hear the screaming. And I enjoy putting myself through that sometimes. That's a different story. Let's go.
I told myself on leg days, I don't want this to happen to me literally and figuratively, but in the morning, I hope I wake up, and I have no disrespect to those that are, but I hope I feel what a paraplegic feels like. I know.
That was a shit thing to say. For those of you that know the current state of my body as of right now, you can see I was like moving around, squirming, getting my shoulder to come out. I'm essentially a paraplegic. You'll need somebody taking care of you 24/7. I would not be able to live anything like I was back then. If anything, I was just a gym girl who just had a sick leg day the day before. But not a fucking paraplegic, man. God damn, that was a dick thing to say.
Yeah, I know. I don't know how else to describe it. That's literally what I told myself every single time in the gym.
Man, your self-talk is rubbish.
I'm gonna work until I feel like my legs have been blown up in the wall or something.
Yeah,
I don't know how to describe. I train my arms until my arms fall off. I train my legs until they fall off. That's the point.
There you fucking go.
Yeah. Trying to be like politics, point me out for all my little wrongdoings because people doing like
bruv, that's holding yourself accountable. Politics? You think this was political? Dude, fix. I'll try not to overreact anymore. This was me from years ago. I'm a totally different man now. Come on.
They'll only remember the bad things, even if the bad thing is just as little as that. You get me?
No, I feel you. I'm just playing devil's advocate with
it. Yeah, exactly. I'm just you're throwing dirt on my name. Shut up, Oscar. I go to the gym, Guildford. I've never really been to the sports park.
What have you chosen
over
the sports park?
Well, I live close to it.
Okay, well, maybe. Okay.
But last year, I lived close to the sports park, but I still chose their gym because the offer, you know, £139 for 9 months, they choose 2 gyms. So I chose the one at home, and I chose this one, so bang, you know, I saved quite a lot of money.
Yeah. I went to the sports park last year.
Cumulatively.
I remember I went with 2 different people, and one of them like really pushed me to do everything, and then the second, and then you know they clearly knew their stuff sort of thing, and then I went with my mate Kieran. I didn't ask him to listen, but I hope he is. And Kieran wasn't as avid to push me, and so I kept complaining about it.
Who's Kieran?
Kieran is my friend.
Oh, right. Okay.
From my flat last year.
Wait, first year, what did you say? Where did you stay?
I stayed in Surrey Way. Surrey Court Way.
Oh, just around here?
Yeah, just around Court Way.
Alright, okay. So you're local?
I am. Yeah, last year.
I stayed in Manor Park. I went to a gym which is like a half an hour walk away from me. Had time on the first year, you know. Talking from a second year's perspective, it's not stress. It was back to the days when life was easy.
Do you feel like your routines of fitness and health and stuff are gonna not crumble, but like,
it will diminish when I've got priorities and kind of want to do something big with myself. I want to do something with myself that will inspire people.
What sort of thing?
I mean, obviously I want
to. Fast forward, as opposed to what I have this year, I'm going after my childhood dream and becoming a pro wrestler.
You have to floor the flat. Oh my god!
But hey, learning about all this other extra shit is good too. So, hey, if this may be the thing that's going to get me to where I want to be, then so be it. If pro wrestling is going to be the thing, as you can see, the replica of the WCW US Heavyweight Championship, Chris Jericho action figure. Who knows where this will come to, but I'm excited to see it. Let's go.
Every success story, when you come around to it, is almost the same. Once upon a time, not a lot of people knew you, and what those people know you for, and see you become the person you are today. It's like how Eminem said in his song Fall, I'm doing it for the kid in the mirror that's lip syncing, the rest of the people I don't really care. Gonna be doing it for those that obviously go through a hard time and just want to do something for themselves.
So you climbed the ladder, the economic ladder, to the top, and you became a superstar millionaire. What do you reckon you would do with your? What do you reckon you would do to inspire people from that perspective?
Superstar millionaire. You know what? I like
from
the sound of that.
If you get there,
I like the sound of that.
Obviously, a bunch of motivational videos saying, "Oh, this could be done."
Where are you coming with this? Where are you coming up with this stuff? Dude, my man's speaking my future into existence when I was 21. Fuck, wow, okay.
And just to strike an emotional chord of people and whatnot. But how would I see people?
It's all about making people feel.
Obviously,
there you go.
It's not a matter of if, it's a matter of when. Life is all about expecting the unexpected. Meet my first love again. And just say, right, you met me at a time when I was like this. And now look at
you.
Your boy is finna turn a man. Alright?
Yeah.
Ooh,
yeah.
Java!
You didn't want to be with me when I was broke. Now I'm getting rich.
Oh no, not that fucking, what's that, that song, Lifestyle, I was referencing to that.
Flex on the X. Literally.
Flex on the X.
After this song,
I wasn't even born in the era this title was created in.
Doing something that inspires people. I'm doing this as well as doing a hard degree, as well as working with a business in my spare time. So,
yeah, cool. Business, what's going on?
Actually, we held an event
last week. Multi-level marketing. Fuck multi-level marketing, man. Hey, look, we all live and learn, and it was what it was, and even though I did all these experiences, I didn't get my degree from Surrey. So if you guys follow pro wrestling, you see Cody Rhodes' story of Roman Reigns, I'm here to finish my story. So he's a big inspiration to me.
We had a good turnout. Just know me and a few other people from uni were working on this mad project. I'm not going to give that much details on air as of right now, because it's just, I can't summarize it in the 2 minutes that we have on air. If you've been on your own as much as I've been on my own, like quite a lot, grew up an only child, and just did a lot of stuff by myself, there's no balance in between whether you're a very interested person or you're just a very dead person. Yeah, there's no
only child, is that what you're saying?
No, I spent a lot of time alone.
Okay.
But only child, but you can honestly, you can tell a little bit though.
spent a lot of time on my own, but what were you doing in that time? That's what you need to ask yourself. Let's continue with the video.
It's on Only Child.
Do you find you can gauge it with a little Only Child radar? If you meet someone you're like, I can tell. And what is it?
I don't know, probably have to be in the group. They have to be in the group. And if they stand out a little bit, if they stand out just a tad bit, if they don't really integrate with the group as much as everyone else does, because obviously you have older brothers and stuff like that, you know, listening to the same music and doing the same things, or younger brothers as well. But obviously you can just tell they're used to company that's their own age. They're used to being in their own age range, depending on who you are. And yeah, but that's very subjective. Anyway, actually now I've got to wait until the song finishes.
Damn, that was it. I'm pretty sure I recorded a little bit more from that. There's some things that I do agree with that I said 5 years ago that I agree in 2024. Some things I'm thinking you could have did that better. You could have assessed things on a more macro basis. You could have did a bit of research into some of the questions that you were asking too. Like, the whole point of my Crossword Chronicles podcast was to get absolutely best out of my guests. And this was essentially my first podcast where I did bring on a guest. Did fairly well when it comes to asking questions, but there was still room for improvement. If you haven't listened to any of the previous parts, they should be there on my channel before you've seen this one. Take care. God bless.